Hi, folks. I'm Bob Schrupp, physical therapist.
Brad Heineck, physical therapist.
We are the most famous physical therapists on the internet.
And our opinion, of course, Bob.
Brad, science says 1 minute of this exercise is equal to 45 minutes of jogging. Isn't that intriguing?
That is intriguing.
I bet you that pulled a lot of people in here. So
you got some ears open, Bob.
But we're not lying. It wasn't just clickbait. This actually was a study that was done by McMaster University in Ontario, Canada. And they studied interval training. Interval training is kind of a high burst of exercises,
right,
followed by kind of a rest period or lower intensity exercise.
Right.
And I'm going to go over that in just a second.
Okay.
Show you the results, but it was very interesting how it kind of compared to 45 minutes of just slow working out on a bicycle.
So, sure.
But before we do that, if you are new to our channel,
yes,
please take a second to subscribe to us. We provide videos on stay healthy, fit, pain-free, and we upload every day. And also go over to Facebook and like us, because Brad and I, let's get the violin music out.
Yeah.
As children, we're not liked, and now we're trying to turn it all around, and we're trying to see if there's a few people out there that'll like us on Facebook. So, Brad?
Yeah, it'll go well, Bob.
All right, so this study, McMaster's University, what they did, Brad, is they had three groups of people. First group did nothing. We know a lot of people like that, don't we?
Right.
And unfortunately, if you're in that category, we're going to move you into one of these other groups. The second group, what they did is they biked on a stationary bike for 45 minutes, kind of at a moderate intensity.
Sure.
Okay. The third group, what they did is they started off, they're on the stationary bike yet.
Mm-hmm.
They, for 2 minutes, they just biked kind of slow, you know, just kind of a warm-up.
Right,
you know?
Yep.
Then for 20 seconds, they picked it up and they went as fast as they could.
Good.
They call it sprinting in bike?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what I call it.
Yeah. So they sprinted on the bike for 20 seconds.
Yep.
They did another 2 minutes of just slow, you know, kind of cooling down.
Yep.
You know. Another 20 seconds of the sprinting. And we're moving on here. 2 minutes of the slow, 20 minutes of the sprinting, and finished up with a 2 minute cool down.
It's a lot of twos, Bob.
Yep, it's a lot of twos. But you take, they sprinted once, they sprinted twice, they sprinted three times for a total of just 1 minute of really high intensity exercise.
Sure, yep.
The rest of it was just kind of a, you know, slow, moderate.
2, 4, 6, 8, so 9 minutes total.
Yeah, so it's really a 9 minute workout. We're being a little deceptive, but it was 60 seconds of really high intensity.
Right.
And what they found in comparing these two groups now, this one, of course, did not get any better, and you know, obviously. But in the group that went for 45 seconds, they found they were exactly equivalent as far as their cardiovascular health had improved.
Mm-hmm.
And they even biopsied the muscles, and they found out the muscles were the same as far as the energy producing, what is it, mitochondria? What do they all have in there, Brad?
Right. I didn't read the study, so I'm not sure what they have, but
they found oxygen producing muscles and energy producing muscles,
sure,
cells were the same.
Okay.
So in other words, I mean, it's really cool. You really, you know, if you don't have time, you really can do these more high intensity exercises and get in good shape.
Right.
For someone who has time, I would do a little bit of both. And that's
sure
what I do right now. I run.
Right.
And then I also try to include some high intensity exercises.
Sure.
So today what we're going to do, we're going to actually, let's get rid of this, Brad. Let's get it out of the way. We're going to show you some of the high intensity exercises that you can do at home without equipment. And then we'll show you what you can do for the 2 minutes too. Now you can do, we're going to show you five of them. So this is almost like a 10 minute workout.
Sure.
You do the high intensity for just 20 seconds.
Yep.
And then you do the core workout for about 2 minutes.
Are we going to time the 20 seconds or?
No, we're not going to time. I mean, we're just going to kind of start showing you, you know.
They can do that at home.
Yeah, they can do it at home. And you can pick which one of these you want to do. I mean,
sure,
you can do all five, or you can repeat each one.
Right.
I mean, you can just keep doing the same one if you want.
If you happen to be a runner, you can go out and jog and sprint.
Yep.
I used to do that.
Absolutely. What do they call that? Well, interval training.
Interval training.
But didn't they also call it fartleks?
Yeah, you can call it that. I never
quite understood
that.
That's a German term, I think.
Yeah, I never really understood it, but that's
I never really understood it either. So, okay, the first one, you know, first off, again, you're going to want to warm up a little bit, Brad, and maybe just some. All right, we'll pretend you warmed up a little bit because The first one that you can try is just quick sidesteps.
Oh, yeah.
So when I do it, you'll be otherwise.
Yeah, we'll bump into each other.
So, you know, just kind of, these are the old basketball thing, Brad. We used to do a lot of these.
And you're going to need a bigger space than this.
Yeah. So for 20 seconds, and I used to do these, Brad. I used to run up my stairs and then come down and do sidesteps like this.
Really?
Yeah.
And the lower you get yourself, the harder they are.
Yeah, it is, exactly. So you can do that for 20 seconds. You're going to feel it.
Sure.
So, all right, the next one is mountain climbers, Brad.
Okay.
Now, a little difficult. Don't do these on a table.
Right, yeah.
We're only doing them
on the floor. But this works out pretty good. Oh, look at that.
Oh, there goes his microphone.
Hello, anybody there?
If these are something that you've never tried before, you might start by just going one leg up, you know, real slow, Brad. You know, yeah, exactly like that.
Right. So, you know, as it gets better,
then you can start picking it up.
Sure.
Now, what we failed to show, Brad, why don't you go ahead and get down, is that in between.
Oh, yeah.
So what I recommend is doing a little bit of core workout while you're resting. So you did the 20 seconds, then you lay down, and you can start with a little bit of core workout. Again, if you're a beginner, you can just start by just touching the heels like this and do this for a couple minutes. You're kind of catching your breath a little bit, and then you can also. My shorts always go out right up.
I know,
you
got to get some tape. We got some duct tape we could take them up with.
And if you get a little more better, you can start doing some fluttering like this.
Right. That's quite a bit harder if you haven't done
much. Yeah, it's quite a bit harder. So that one is not going to let you rest as much.
Right.
So
right.
Next one, Brad, is we did the burpees. Next one is just, what I call bed burpees.
Yes.
I invented these. Now, normal burpees are you go all the way down, you kick out, and come back up again. What I hate, Brad and I hate about these, is right here when you're going down, look how rounded I am.
It puts a fair amount of stress on your low
on
back.
On your low back.
If you got a healthy back and you like doing them, that's fine.
Yeah, I have no problem with it, but as you get older, it's not something you want to do.
Things change.
So you're going to use a countertop or you're going to use a bed.
Yep.
And what you're going to do, Brad will show from the side.
Sure, yep.
So basically you're going to go down, you're going to kick out, kick back, and then you can kick up like this.
Oh.
Down, kick back.
Wow, I'm getting it cool. Yeah. I'm getting it. This is kind of fun, Bob.
Yeah.
I'm going to do these tonight before I go to bed. Get my wife all excited.
Brad, it's a family show. Okay. And I'll go to another core one, Brad.
Oh, yeah.
So now this is a good one just for the obliques. Lay on your side. This leg's underneath, this one's up like this. I put this hand here, and I start just doing a little bit of obliques here. And again, I'm catching my breath, but I'm working my core.
Sure. This is one of those things that's nice to have a timer so you can actually look at a clock on the wall.
Yeah, you're gonna wanna do it for 2 minutes, yeah.
Do it on your cell phone so you can see it, but don't just guess because you really should keep on track.
I just watched this show last night called The Good Doctor. Really good show.
Yeah.
And he's autistic and he times everything. He's brushing his teeth. It's got to be interesting. All right. Next one, Brad, is just regular old jumping jacks.
Jacks.
You know, anybody can do these because, yep. Oh, our mic's going to fly around, isn't it?
No.
But it's working your whole body and, you know, you can pick up the speed if you want to.
And it's going to depend on the individual.
Yeah, for some people that's going to be too easy.
Right. Yeah. And some people it's going to be just about right.
Right. And then if that's too easy, stick with one of the other ones.
Right.
Then you can get your heart rate up on those. So, and then, you know, what I'm going to do is go ahead while I'm working my core a little bit here. I'm going to go ahead and just do opposite arm, opposite leg.
I like this one.
Again, works the back, works the core. Catching my breath. Working out good. I'm kicking Brad.
Yeah. This is one.
Yeah, the ball works out really good for this.
If you're a new beginner.
If you're a new beginner, this really gives you stability.
Or if you've got a back problem, but it's doing fairly good, I use the ball because of that. It really stabilizes that back.
Yeah.
And you still get a good workout. But, you know, this is, again, the cool down. This is the rest period, so we're just doing some active recovery.
Right. And then the last one, Brad.
Oh, yes.
High steppers.
Yep. Okay.
It's kind of hard to do. I think that ball's going to fall.
Yeah. No, it's fine, Bob.
So you can just put your hands out.
You don't have to put your hands out. You can just work it like this. This is like that Seinfeld episode when they're running the
race?
The hallway.
I don't remember that one.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I remember that race, too, but no, I'm thinking of a different one. Oh, yeah. You can tell I'm starting to breathe a little harder, Bob.
Yeah. And then you're going to want to cool down for the last part. Yeah. And I don't know, you got anything else you want to do core-wise?
Oh, core-wise?
Good planning on my part, isn't it?
Yeah. No, I think we can do the bridge.
Oh, yeah, there we go.
The
that's
hips.
A good, yeah.
That's a good one.
Good.
You can make it a little harder like this.
Because this one's not that hard, but you're cooling down. Yep, there you go.
And you can alternate those legs. And, you know, you're laying flat. You can relax and breathe a little bit. Okay. We can do a little rotation. Especially if it's your last one, you're cooling down.
Yep, you're cooling down, exactly.
You got your 9 minutes in. That seems kind of weird, Bob. I got my 9 minutes in this morning.
Yep. But, again, you know, that 9 minutes is equal to 45 minutes. So, heck, you know.
You bet.
And, you know, this kind of relates to our little problem here, Brad. Remember, we can fix just about anything.
Except?
A broken heart. Oh, I put it right on you last time. It looked kind of cool. I'm going to do it again.
Yeah. Well, we got this thing up here that's the same color, but we'll work on that.
All right. Thanks a lot.